So hello there, today I have a new species that I want to start the playlist. It's one of the most famous of all the Rhinocerosbeetles on this world, and it's one of the first that has been described, Megasoma Actaeon from South America. Here in this box I keep them since already a long time. It was last year in May. They have been 70 grams and 68 grams. That's more than 1.5 years ago. And last time I checked it was the end of July. One larva was 90 gram, another one I transported to another box. Now let's see what happened to this larva, whether we already can see something in here. 2 months. No, that's more than 4 months ago that we checked it, so let's have a look what happened. I placed some white rotten wood pieces into the box that you can see here, so that the larva would have a chance to eat more from that material if she's still hungry. And now I think that she has pupated somewhere down here in this edge here, so I will try to find her and to see what stage the larva is in, or if there's already... Oh, there's a pupa. It seems like there's a pupal chamber down here. So I will try to open it carefully. Here, in this edge, is a little hole that you can see. And also from outside you can see here there's a structure on the side of the box here. On the bottom you see this round dot with a compacted material around. So let's see whether we can find here something. We probably try to turn it down like this. Oh yeah, it's a pupa. Now we have to, oh, it's such a nice big pupa. Look at this one. It's a pupa of a male. And of course I don't want to disturb it along here under this condition, but start to prepare an artificial pupal chamber for that nice animal just in a second, so that we don't lose a lot of time. So that's one of the sides of the box, this one is the other one. And then afterwards, as you can see here down here, is a prepupa of Actaeon in a pupal chamber. Also for this one I'm going to prepare this kind of a peat pot method to give the larva the chance to develop to an animal in a secure kind of a box here in this two peat pots. So that's what we're doing. And let's have a look. We open this structure just to give you. This is the skin of this pupa I present, and of course now this pupa here I just place inside of this peat pot with a little bit a shortened upper part of the other box so that they can go into each other. So you can see the structure of the pupal chamber is pretty long, so they will need it to have a good development. That's it, like this. Huh? Well, that's for the pupal. And now I wanted to show you the skin of the larva. That's it. As you can see, all the the legs are completely visible. They only shed the larval skin here, and this was a big one. I guess it was a big larval. Also the head, you can see how it split open in these three parts like this, so that the pupal skin could come out, and it was pretty big larval. How heavy is the pupal skin here? We have a look. But it's of course covered with earth, also it's around 2 grams for a larval like this. So it's a nice view, because now we know that it won't last very long until these animals come out of their pupal skins. I just cleaned them a little bit. That's the prepupa larva of Megasoma Actaeon here. Pretty big also, so let's see how heavy this larva is. It's 50.6 grams. And of course also this one, now I put the larva into this kind of a peat pot, and also on the other side I place so that's it for the larva too. And now let's have a look at the pupal chamber. Especially interesting how the inner surface of this pupal chamber is made. It's completely flattened and cleaned, and normally there's not a little piece of dirt that is not flattened to the walls of this nice oval-shaped pupal chamber. And we can see how long it is. It's also, this one measures around, this is around 15 centimeters long, the whole pupal chamber. Also, there are some earthworms in the substrate, but I hope they couldn't harm the larvae in here, and it doesn't seem so, because the pupal chamber, they look okay. And for the pupa, it was right that we took her out, so we can save her, and we can have a place her now on a piece of wet sand, and keep them warm and covered for the next, I would say, 1 month, and then after 1 month we have a look whether they have developed. Thanks for watching.